And now we will learn something that attorneys are required to do as part of their books and records: tracking expenses and costs per client. Attorneys are required to track costs per client. This is especially important if you are billing the client for the job-related costs. The profit and loss by job report is what most companies would use to track their income and expenses for a particular customer or a particular job. With attorneys, we can call this report profit and loss by client, but it's basically the same report and it does the same thing. However, even though writing checks and entering bills for an attorney would be the same as writing checks and entering bills for any other company, the only additional step that you need to take when you write checks and enter bills is input the client name in the window when you enter the check or the bill. It's that simple. And you will usually put the client name in the bottom right of the window. It's so, so simple. For example, let's imagine on March 20, Ross wrote check number one for $200 to the intern research team for work done on the Allen Arby client case. Let's take a look at how we would record this check. From the icon bar, click check. Make sure that you bring the date forward to March 20 of 2017. Now, the company whom we paid was the intern research team, and the money amount was $200. Okay? Now, because this is a handwritten check, we remove the print later and we leave the check number one, which is what QuickBooks suggests. Now, obviously this check is for the expense of research. But this is not general research expense. This research expense is specific to this particular client, Allen Arby. Now, in this video, we are not going to bill Allen yet. We're just going to record what we paid and make sure we know it's for Allen. So in this video, we will remove the check mark where it says billable. And in a future video, I will talk all about billable expenses. When we click Save and Close at the bottom of the window, we can open up the trial balance and see that research expense showed up as a general expense for $200. However, the most important report in this video is the profit and loss by client. When we open it up, we can see that even though we earned $1,000 from Allen Arby in income, we had to pay $200 for the Allen Arby case in order to earn that income because we needed to do the research. So right now, our profit from the Allen Arby case has been reduced down to $800. Let's take a look at a second example. Let's imagine on March 21, Ross wrote check number two for $400 to the intern research team for work done on the Candy Charles case. Same company, same service, but meant for a different client. Basically, it's the same thing. Click to open the check window. QuickBooks remembers we left off at check number two. The date of the check is the 21st. The company we wrote the check to was intern research team. The money amount of the check was $400. QuickBooks happens to remember the particular expense that's associated with that vendor, and it's very convenient to write the check. The only extra step is coming to the bottom right and clicking directly under the word customer job just to bring the arrow. Then click on the arrow and choose which particular customer or client in this case. In this case, the client is Candy Charles. And again, there will be a later video teaching about how to bill the client. So for now, we'll remove the check mark. When we click Save and Close, we can notice on the trial balance that research expense in general went up. And we could always double-click this total and look at every check for research expense, and we can even see which client it's for. However, the best report in this case is the profit and loss by client. And now you can see, even though you earned $5,200 from candy, you needed to spend $400 in research to be able to earn that $5,200. So right now your profit from candy has been reduced down to $4,800. Now this third example illustrates a couple of important points. Imagine March 22, we received bill number 8472 from Verizon for $700 for international phone calls for the Allen Arby client case. Well, let's take a look at what happens when we record this. From the icon bar, click bill. Okay, the company that sent us the bill was Verizon. The date of the bill was March 22nd. The reference number on the bill was 8472. And the amount of the bill was $700. Now, you can click in the bottom left to choose the specific expense. In this case, the expense was international phone call expense. But this particular bill was for the Allen Arby client case. And again, for now, let's just remove the billable, and I will explain about billable expenses in a later video. Now, when we click Save and Close and we open the trial balance, you see the accounts payable feature has been activated because we now owe to a vendor $700. And in the profit and loss by client, you can see that your profit for Allen has decreased. So far, you have only earned $1,000 from Allen, or at least only recorded $1,000 worth of invoices for Allen. However, you have two expenses that relate to the Allen Arby case, the international phone calls, as well as the research expense. So far, you only billed Allen for $1,000, so QuickBooks only acknowledges $1,000 in income for that client, but you have a total of $900 of expenses for that same client, and so far, with all the work you did, you only made $100. That's why you need both the trial balance for the general totals as well as the profit and loss by job.